This is a D2L demonstration in version 10.3 of the Discussions tool and how to add an assessment. I'm going to go over to the discussion board and show you a couple of options. The way that this is set up right now is that each discussion topic is just set up to be open for the entire class. I will do a separate video on how to grade group discussions. You can see from these discussion posts that there are already posts, some threads started, and also some replies. So the question is, how do I grade this? If I were to go into this first assignment, which was to post an email, there's no option to assess because I haven't set that up yet. You would have to click on the topic and scroll through looking for who posted what, and it can be kind of cumbersome to grade. Each thread is listed individually and the replies are embedded in here, so you have to go through and either sort by student name here to find their original posts, and then to find replies you have to go into each of these threads and scroll through and decide or find who has replied. You can again sort here, which is helpful, but it's very cumbersome to follow one student's activity. So if I go back out to the email topic, I want to show you also that you can search up in the text box up here. So if you have a particular student that you want to search for all of their posts, you can do that. It will bring up any time that they have posted, whether it's in as their original thread, like here for trainee one, or if it's embedded as a reply in someone else's thread. So that can be very helpful for you to search for a student. But we're really assessing each individual topic here, so you do have to go topic by topic. And so if you were looking at the memo, you can either search by thread and go into the memo, into the thread itself to find the replies, sort it, or again, go up here and search for a particular student, and then that will show you every thread that that person has posted into. Now to find trainee, what did I look for? Trainee 2, here I would have to click inside of that message and look for the post that was by trainee 2. So still, this was a reply, that's why it's listed down here in white. It can be very cumbersome. So let me show you an option to make this a little bit easier. What I'm going to do is go back out, and you can either do this from, well, let's go from the regular discussion list because that's where you'll go to first off. So I'm going to scroll down and I want to add an assessment for these items. This is an assignment they have to complete. So if I go in here and edit this, one of the tabs that you have across the top is called assessment. Click assessment. And now you can choose which grade item to attach this to. So since this is the one on the email, I'll attach it to my email grade item. I had already set that up previously. If you don't have the grade item set up yet, you can do that here. And then you can enter the score. So if it's out of 10 points, for example, I enter that point value. Save and close. Now here I am again at my discussion list, and I'll scroll down and find that topic. So here's my draft email topic, and now you see it has a little notation that it includes assessment. What this allows me to do then is, right from this drop-down menu, I can choose assess topic. So you'll want to wait till this discussion time is over, so if they have like a week to do this or whatever, wait till the end of the week when all students are finished posting, and now you go back in to assess. So I go to assess topic. It'll bring up a list of all my students, and then I can start going through student by student. You can sort this. I'd probably want to do this in some kind of order. These are mock students, so they're kind of different, but so I can go through it here and click on topic score. Or I can go to the assessment tab, and then this brings up their names kind of in a condensed version list. So I can start with trainee number one. What this will do is pull up all the posts made by this student within the topic, whether it was their initial or if it was a reply. So you get them on one page. Very similar to how some of you use the print feature in our previous version, where you could pull all the posts together from one student. This will tell me a summary that there was three posts. And then if you scroll down, you see you have the ability to leave some feedback. But down here, this is going to show you, here's the original post made by the student. And if I keep going down, now you see this is a reply. The reason you know it's a reply is because it's their post here, and it says it was a reply to this person. If they posted 10 things, you would be able to scroll all the way through and look at all of the posts made by this one student. So you can easily, or at least more easily, tell, okay, what has this student done for this particular assignment, which was the email. So now I can enter a score here. If you're ready to publish that to the gradebook, you can click the published box. If you're not wanting to do that until you've graded all of them, you can just enter the score, save and close. See, the score is listed here, but it's not published. So then once I go through and grade all of these, here's student number two, two posts. I can scroll through here. There's his post, and there's a reply. So then I can go in here and give him, maybe I'm giving him a score of 9, save and close. There it is. And now on this page, once I've graded everyone, there is a button to publish all scores to grades. So then I can do that. Are you sure? Yes. Then if I went to my gradebook, here it is right here, the email, and you can see that these scores are here. Now, that's the way to grade them from the discussion board. You can also grade discussions through the gradebook. As long as you go in, first of all, and attach that assessment piece to the discussion. Remember, it was going here to discussions, and we'll just pick the next thing here for memo. I have to edit this. Go to assessment. Now, this happens to be the memo, so I'm going to choose my grade item that says memo. Enter my score out of, save and close. That's attaching the assessment. Now, I can grade that from the discussion board just like I did with the email by going here and going assess topic. Your other option, once you've included the assessment at the discussion level, is to go right to the gradebook. If the student has posted to an item that has been linked to the gradebook, so we have done the assessment piece in the discussion area, linked it to a gradebook, you'll get a little notation here right in your gradebook that indicates that there is some activity that has been done. So for trainee number one, I see that he's done something. I can go to my gradebook, click right on that little icon. This brings up the same screen that I saw from the discussion board, where I can see how many posts were made. I have the ability to enter a score, feedback, and when I scroll down past that, I then see all of the posts made by the student for that particular topic. So it really helps you, so you're not hunting and pecking through all of these different threads trying to find where that student put in his or her replies. It brings them all into one single page where you can scroll through. So in this case, I can put in a score, and I could publish it immediately and save it. I'll click overwrite. And there's the score. Now, this assessment feature is not something new. It's been out there for a while, but we really didn't use it a whole lot because we had that grid style that really pulled things together easily. So this is something that I would encourage you to use, especially when you have topics that are open for the entire class. Like I said, I'll do a separate one on group discussions. So it's adding the assessment and then being able to assess the topic right here.